So another thing during these tutorials, while since we have already discussed about installation, another thing which needs to take care is what are our databases we will be working for this training. For talent training, I will be primarily working with Oracle. I used to work earlier, or I used to provide training with MySQL earlier, but MySQL is not that much frequently used in live industry. Even though MySQL has already been bought by Oracle. So I prefer recommending Oracle installation rather than using MySQL or any other database. Oracle is also free. Oracle XE 11g version, 11g XE version is completely free. You can download it. So downloading SQL Oracle database, you just Google Oracle 11g XE download. And the first version will redirect you to the Oracle website. From there, you just accept the license agreement, and depending upon your computer configuration, you can either download 64-bit or you can either download 32-bit. So Oracle installation is also pretty easy, nothing big. Only one thing where you need to take care is while you are installing Oracle XE, just click on next, next, next. At one stage, you will reach at this particular screen where you need to set your system user password. So make sure you set it very easy to remember. You don't forget it, because if you forget it, it is difficult to recover. So just set it as simple as possible. And you just need to confirm the password. So once you have installed Oracle, you will see one new utility which has been added to your computer programs is SQL command line. Just for accessing the command line, just go to SQL, run SQL command line. And before you can actually run your command line, you also need to start your database. You do that by going to the start database, search a program, and click on start database. Once you see this screen that tells you that your Oracle database has been started, and you can connect to database using connect button or using connect command. What is my username? I don't remember my password. So connect using. I'm able to connect using system user. I had set my password as Oracle only. And then once you have connected to your system user, and then you need to create another user for your general use. It's not recommended that you use system user for working with talent also, because system user has got a lot of tables, system related tables, and when you fetch your database using system user, you will see all of unwanted tables also coming into the talent server. So that is unnecessary lot of trouble. So you can create your user by the command which I'm going to show you. So as you can see, you can create a dummy user, Bharat. You can set its password by using the command identified by the password. And this you have to do using SQL command line, which I have just shown you. And then to that user, you need to grant some sufficient privileges so that user can connect to your Oracle database. And then you also need to define that you need to define the table space, because that user is going to create tables. So that user needs a table space to create the table. And you can grant the table space or alter the database default table space in the commands I've shown here. The last installation is installing the SQL developer. You need a SQL developer because to access your Oracle database, the SQL developer is the best IDE for accessing your Oracle database. IDE stands for Integrated Development Environment, wherein you can access your database in the best graphical interface possible. So for installing the SQL developer, again just Google download SQL developer. Again, the first link will redirect you to the Oracle website. And there you just accept the license agreement. And in SQL developer website, there are various types of SQL developer, like with JDK and without JDK. As SQL developer uses Java to install, Java to work with your databases. So it is always recommended that you download the SQL developer which has got JDK inbuilt, so that you don't run into Java issues, because SQL developer has requires Java 8, whereas Talent requires Java 7. So it may result in some incompatibility. So to prevent such issues, it is always recommended that you install SQL developer like Windows 64 bit with JDK included, and you download it. And it is basically an application based interface. You don't have to install the SQL developer. You can just give you some zip folder, and you unzip that folder, and then you will see one application, SQL developer.exe. You just create a shortcut to that application. You will see some exe shortcut being created like that. Once you open a SQL developer, you will see some screen like that. You first need to create a connection to your database. You can use the same connection which you had created while creating your which you had created using system user. Just click on plus and provide the connection details. Normally, you just need to specify your username and password and give some connection name. It may be username itself. And the rest of the parameter remains the same, because whatever the default which has been set in, you can use that one themselves. It does not need to change. You will see some window like that. You can just try to run some basic stuff. You can see whether it is running fine or not. You will see some data like that. If it's coming, means you are correctly able to fetch connect to your Oracle database. So this is all we discussed about the built-in connection, and the last part is repository connection. You create a repository connection by going to the repository tab, and there if you want to create the connection to your Oracle database, you go to the metadata and go to the DB connection, and then right click and select create connection. give a connection name, maybe test. Click on next. Then under the DB type, you specify what type of database you would like to connect. For Oracle, there are two types or two ways to connect to Oracle. One is with service ID and another one is with the service name. So you will select something with the service ID, because service ID you already may be having. Service ID is basically a database name, and you can connect using either ways, using service ID or service name. So here you specify the login, the username which you have created, then password, then server, that is localhost, and service ID is going to be XE, and specify here whatever. Then you can click on check connection to see whether your connection is successful. As you can see, connection is successful. So you can click on finish, or since I already have the connection, so I don't click on finish, I have already click on cancel. So once you have created some connection like that to the metadata, then you need to retrieve the tables underlying which are there under the particular database. You can do that by using right click on that connection which you have created and select a retrieve schema. So under retrieve schema, firstly you need to specify the table filter to select the tables which you want. If you want all, then you just select the percentage, then click on next. Here by default, whatever the schema you have listed, it will show you, and if you just select that schema, all the tables which are under there, it will be listed. So that is the reason I told you earlier not to use the system user, because if you use the system user, you will see a lot of tables coming up. So you select the tables, and for example, if you want to select the courses table, so you will see talent right side, it's coming, recent status as pending. So this tells you that this particular schema is being fetched to talent, it has not yet fetched. So it is just as of now, recent status is just pending. It will, after some time, it will change to success. As you can see, it has correctly fetched 5 columns into its repository, and its recent status is next. So once you click on finish, you will see all the tables have added and their column names and the key as in the data types. You can also change their data types as well as your name over here. In case you don't like, if you want to keep it whatever the default talent has automatically fetched, then you click on finish. You might be wondering like how talent has fetched the data types and how talent has automatically fetched their length as well as column names. So talent automatically does that based on the top 100 records. For example, if you for your column called name, the top 100 records just hold a string data, then its data type will be string. Similarly for duration and keys, its data type will be bit decimal. You can always change your data types. For example, big decimal you can change here if you don't want, and then you can click on finish. So once we have added those tables under the table schemas, you will see that all the tables like courses underscore new has been added, and we can use that table connection, by just dragging and dropping that connection to the designer. So as you can see, T-Oracle input component has got enabled here, and we can use this component. About how to convert a repository connection, okay, what is the difference between the repository and the built-in connection? Is built-in connection is primarily used for reading data from file. It's created when we drag and drop connection component from the palette. Once you drag the component and create a database or file connection from palette, it is by default a built-in connection. For built-in, the scope is limited to the job where you have created the connection. So you cannot use that connection or the component outside of any other job. For the repository connection, it is normally used for reading the data from a file or a database. It is created when we create a established connection using a repository. Here, scope is broader as compared to building connection, and connection can be shared across all the jobs in your project. A repository connection can also be converted to a built-in connection. Why we convert a repository to built-in? We convert that when a new file is having quite similar structure to our existing file, and you want to read a file that has lots of columns, but at the same time you don't want to share this file connection with anyone else. So we'll see how to convert repository connection to built-in connection, and these are its advantages. So that's all for this tutorial.